Yar-har, fiddly-dee, Beagle Wave Riders, all right with me. Reactions, reviews, right here on your screen. You're watching Blind Wave.
Hey guys, Crew Blind Wave back. I'm Calvin.
I'm Rick.
Jane.
Eric.
Aaron.
And we're back watching Black Sails, Season 2, Episode 3.
Four.
Damn.
Hey, Eric, you should have did it.
Damn. I didn't know.
What happened last episode?
I don't know either.
Last episode where they were on boats.
Yep.
Yeah, and well, we know he's a captain again.
Every episode, they're on boats.
Last episode, I angered Charles Vane.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. So yeah, Captain Lowe was gone.
What'd you do?
Ned Lowe, yes, he is gone.
He pissed off Vane.
Pissed on Vane.
Took his ship. So now the really good, angry, hairy, dirty crew have a ship.
They do have a ship.
Oh yeah, and also Max and that chick and fucking
Jack
had a threesome. At least I think. Shane remembers.
Max, Bonnie, and Jack.
True, yeah. And he's a captain.
Yes, he
now,
is.
Kind of.
And Vane, he
gave
like
him a go ahead.
He gave him the go ahead, and he was like, "Yeah, I'm repairing your reputation."
He said, "You're good now."
Now you know how it feels to come back from the dead.
We have a bit of a timetable. In a week or two, King Philip will return and take his gold off the beach, so we need to get back there. But we need to be able to bring it back into the bay. Who's going to be in control of the fort? All that stuff is going on right now.
And then you went all pirate yesterday.
I went all pirate yesterday?
Yeah. I saw a YouTube comment, and you're like, "We are," but you started A-R-R. Yeah. We are!
I saw that.
I was like, Eric's ready for Black Sails.
Damn it! And then I went to fix it on my phone, and I was tied into a different account. I'm like, I'm too lazy. I'm not going anywhere.
And don't forget, we also found out what the valued cargo was.
Yes.
It is a woman.
It is the daughter of a lord.
Lord Ash.
Yes.
From Boston.
And they were ransomed for $250,000.
Double dollars. Curtain number two.
Yes. The Ash's daughter. Yeah. That's all I have for last one.
No.
Eat the mealworms. They're good for you. I've eaten mealworms.
I'm sure you have.
You were Flint sailing a Spanish warship.
Maybe you should try and lure someone inside.
Yeah.
Get to work.
Ways.
And accuse me, challenge me, fight me, or shut the fuck up about it.
I agree.
Open the gate!
You need a Blind Wave Spanish warship. Maybe they'll bring one of those in Sea of Thieves. Could you imagine having a Spanish warship ship in Sea of Thieves?
Man, cool. It'd have to be like a 20-man boat, though.
We would sink it immediately.
We would find a way.
Because one way or another, he is leaving that fort. And right now, my way is the only way that I can be certain of that.
If he gets the support of the people, he can't use Nassau at all.
But gold changes everybody's minds.
And they'll need the warship to protect them.
Money.
You don't need to worry about him anymore.
No, you do not.
How can you be sure?
Cut his head off.
Sorry, are you asking my opinion?
It's the only person you can trust.
It bothers you, doesn't it? What they think.
Being the villain.
The things you've done. It must be awful being you.
I'm the only one escaped.
So what do you make of this business between Captains Flint and Vane?
A little war propaganda.
Yep.
Lovely performance.
Lovely performance.
Randall Becker.
Randall.
Hopping her along.
Hello, friend.
You're a thief.
Man around the bend has something to say about this business at the fort. Sorry, what are you talking about?
He's one of yours.
Billy?
Oh, he's here?
There's no way.
No way he's here.
Oh my gosh. Fly's buzzing.
I sent him as a warning.
Fuck. Wash him off! hate sand on my neck.
How the hell did you get sand on your neck?
Great Lakes.
He was eating those.
I've been to Michigan. Michigan is all sand.
He was eating those maggots.
I'm not in Michigan.
I don't eat maggots. Gillworms.
Flat ass fucking shitty football.
He's not. The only one who can stop this is Flint. I just have to find someone to convince him.
Silver?
She's saying it's impossible for Vane to change his mind.
In the most immediate danger, and you would be the who have enabled him, encouraged his violence. You ask if I care about him. How dare you? Get out of my house.
She's always been setting Vane and Flint against each other.
She has a help for sure.
Well, she's always bouncing between who she's siding with, too.
Yeah.
She takes everything personally.
You must care for her a great deal. Not once a night did you so much as look in my direction.
I've seen enough to know to keep my distance from you.
The situation was not of my making. You'd be amazed what can change in a week in my bed.
It's magic whore.
I'm feeling quite indispensable.
It cannot be cast into doubt the moment the pleasure fades, and for that you cannot just fuck him. You must seduce him. Yes, there is a difference. The arch in your back when he thinks he is making you finish. The look in your eyes when you finally breathe again because you would do anything he asked in that moment.
Impossible.
Anything at all without hesitation.
I know all the time.
The story you tell him that night about when you were a little girl.
Just so we're clear, I still fuck the shit out of him. Yes?
Yes. Is there anything else you would like to add?
No, I don't think so.
Who are those men camped out in your family storehouse?
What men?
Perfect.
I love how he gets others in
there. He can't be on the ship right now.
Give him a drink.
Get.
Shit.
Find the Ouija board.
You're a thief, he says. Or something. What happened?
Everybody in the place cheers.
Yo, crew.
Well, now he needs a boat.
Yeah.
What?
What?
At least 28 men.
Oh, damn.
Dang, that's...
That's more than half his crew.
In addition to these new recruits, you will be granted command of their ship as well.
Huh?
The body stays here.
A ship as well?
Yeah. For the greater part of the crew, they can kick him off.
That's pretty much voting a new captain.
Yeah.
Am I right to assume that a proposal such as this would...
Don't look at him, talk to me.
Son is impertinent, Lieutenant. Son is indulged. My son is self-righteous. You have done enough to damage the good name of this family.
Damn.
I would ask that you keep both your mouth and your legs
firmly shut. Oh,
I support it.
I find his argument persuasive. I find his intent to be good and true. And I find yours wanting, sir.
Oh, shit!
Fuck me.
I will be relaying my findings to Admiral Hennessy in short order. And now I think it's time you left, sir.
Did he finish his meal?
No, time to leave. Time to leave after you're done eating.
Eating? He's like, you mean now?
That'd be you. I think it's time you leave, Shane.
I'm taking this.
What? Oh.
Well, good on him. I mean, Thomas is a truly convicted Christian man trying to... do the right thing.
I'll go to bed.
Did you just ask my father to leave his own house?
I can't believe that worked. Oh, his hair doesn't always look like that?
No.
That's weird.
We've seen him both ways. Both.
Oh. I don't sleep anymore.
American dream. Right,
shut the fuck up.
I've seen you at my service. Kept my distance. I've seen you there. I am committed to this end. But it is a long road, and I will need your help to see it through.
Oh, I don't know. Damn it.
Well, God damn it, Shane. If he hadn't said that, it wouldn't have happened. Sit your ass down.
Sorry. God damn it. Oh, ruins all the parties.
Ruins all the parties?
Yeah, it's my birthday. Wait, what?
It's because you pooped everywhere.
That Lord Ash?
How can I help?
I remember
you. Oh, okay, oh, I got one. Shit.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Lieutenant McGraw? My good friend, Lord Peter Ash.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
You don't know.
I thought that was the guy that he was later going to kill.
No, it's the ransoming daughter.
Yeah. It's one Bane's going to kill.
Yeah.
Extort. He wants to help pirates, and pirates have his daughter.
Oh!
I didn't fall then.
I heard the news today. I thought, sigh, it was time to come and see you. I came to help you get it.
Huh. I don't know what it is.
If he fucks her over.
What the hell is he going to do?
Trust him? Why would you trust him?
He's got experience.
Yeah, he does.
He must see something that she doesn't. Or me.
I remember when I first saw it.
Fire.
What? You're not going to do it.
Fire.
Oh, oh shit! Shit. Whatever Calvin says is the opposite.
No, whatever Reaver raises his eyes, I was like, shit, I'm wrong. Definitely wrong.
Oh fuck! That was perfect.
He's not gonna do it. Fire.
Oh, that was a cool episode.
That's what everybody keeps saying, like, Vane's not gonna change. You should change. Vane's not gonna change. You should change. Like, why should I change? He's gonna change.
He hasn't backed down yet.
Yep.
Why start now?
Yep.
Bad feeling. They're gonna weaken themselves, and there's gonna be the.
My first thought is like, go get the gold, bury it, so you don't have to worry about the week or two thing, and then you can deal with this stuff.
They bury it in the sequel. They need a consort ship.
The only thing I know about it.
That's why this whole thing started is because they need to get into the bay and get one of the ships that Vane is keeping
hostage.
None of those ships can get out.
No. And he was blown apart.
They could have before. He did that to prove that he was meaning business there.
Right.
He shot one. They could have came in and got a ship and left. But the issue was that what was to stop Vane from when he arrived with the gold? So what Eric is saying is don't arrive with the gold. Go get the gold. Hide it somewhere. And then come back.
Then come back and do this. Because you have that week to 2 weeks where the king...
Yeah, you have a time period where they're going to have more ships arriving to save the Urca gold.
Yeah.
Go get the Urca gold now. Hide it somewhere, make a map, put an X, you know, the pirate thing to do.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then come back, fight, then go back and get it.
I don't think Vane would allow another ship to go and help Flint.
So
I think
that was his point.
Is like,
if Vane is shutting down all people going in and out of the bay in general, like, how does he have any support at all?
Yeah, so I don't think he'd have too much support.
That. I don't know.
No, he's not preventing them. He shot one whenever he was taking over and stuff like that. The thing that Flint's saying, though, is that what's to stop him from thieving, taking, stopping anybody anytime he wants to?
Yeah.
But you can't bury the gold and use the same men to raid the fort because he won't let them off the ship because they know where the gold is now.
Yeah.
He doesn't trust any of them enough.
Yeah, his issue now, though, is that if he leaves, then he won't regain that position again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So now he's stuck there. If he'd have gone and gotten the gold first and then dealt with the problem of Vane,
it would have been better.
But he needed more men, right?
Yeah, and he needed the consortship.
I mean, he was going to get Hornigold's help and stuff, but Hornigold wants to take care of the fort thing, so you got to take care of that first.
Mm-hmm.
I think Flint and Vane should just work together, share the money. He has a ship. He has a ship.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. How much was on the Urca? It was more than 250,000,
right? Wasn't like 6 million 8 or something like that? 6 million of 8?
Sounds right.
Written down.
6 million Spanish coins or something.
5 million.
5 million.
Yep, that's what I said. Sure. Yeah. Sure wasn't 6?
Yeah, it's 5.
He wrote it down.
Swore it was 6. Maybe he wrote it down wrong.
Maybe I did.
You sure that 5 isn't a 6?
No, I think it's...
They look similar.
That's clearly a 5.
5 sounds much more familiar than 6.
No, there was something about 5,000 pesos to get the chance to get 5 million Spanish dollars, which is the Urca. I believe it's 5.
It's fine. That's close.
You were very close.
I was only off by one.
Yeah.
Million.
One!
Million. His flashbacks are... when you see how Thomas is, it kind of makes it much more heartbreaking if everything that we know about their relationship is true.
There's so much more behind Flint and Barlow and all that stuff than what we know from just season one, you know?
I'm just trying to think back on the stuff that we've already known about him. Like, the idea of... The letter that Barlow wrote was about him being pardoned, but him as a pirate is kind of relevant here. It's like, well, pirates don't get pardons. They're traitors. So, like, even there you can say, well, that's why he's so damn pissed, because this stuff is all going back to this stuff.
Like, the man he's talking about who's behind him, like, behind both thrones, he's talking about Hamilton?
Yeah.
Is he behind spinning the world and all that?
Yeah.
Is it just, I said before, like, Flint's whole thing is just trying to get to Hamilton's dream? Is that what he's trying to do?
I think so.
Well, there's also the thing about how he really cares about how people see him. Like, he was really concerned that people were seeing him as the bad guy. And, like, Flint's like, that's strange. I mean, you did a lot of shit.
Silver. Yeah, silver.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, always do that. Everyone wants to be the hero, right?
But it seemed like it was almost... It seemed like it was more pointed at Flint.
Well, because...
Well, no, it's pointed at Flint because it's also really the last episode when Barlow was saying about you're too worried what they're thinking out there than what's actually going on in here.
And in Flint's mind, he's doing all this for them. Yeah. For the island. Yeah. Not for himself.
Yeah.
So one of those things, too, like, when it comes to how people see you and how you're known as, like, these wise people are like, look, Vane will never break. You'll break. Like, what? Like, it's like a reputation thing. Like, no, I should be the one that never breaks. Sure. See my flag? I have a spit. Yeah.
Yeah.
I killed my best friend.
How is this fort so damn special if it can be taken out by, like, such, like, a small group of people, you know?
Well,
But they need it to defend against King Philip's army or navy.
I think it's just because they're on that weak side.
The bay. Yeah. Like, the bay is where it mainly defends from. But that one side, it hasn't been maintained very well by Hornigold.
And Hornigold knows that it's a weakness. If someone was just coming to attack, they wouldn't know, like, if I sit here, I'll be out of range, I'll be able to attack and do more damage. And then, wasn't it Eleanor who was saying that, like, Charles Vane is doing more in there than what... You know, the last people that were in there weren't maintaining it, taking care of it. They were just sitting in it.
Yeah.
Is it that hard?
That makes sense.
I guess park up the coast a little bit and just all your men get out and storm the island that way.
Yeah, but they have to get through the walls.
Yeah, I guess.
That's why they parked the ship.
They'd have to, like, carry their guns with them.
Already have the men on the beach. Like they said, they have 60 other volunteers from other crews on the beach.
You're also tiring your men by walking. How far you gotta walk?
Well, until D-Day, like, the number of amphibious landings where you could count on one hand.
Yeah,
it's a hard thing to do.
You wouldn't have your mobile gun platform either. You'd have to wheel these giant cannons, you know, through a jungle.
Yeah, and I mean, I'm sure there are other cannons on the island. They're all movable. They could see them, like, where they're gonna go, and move some of the lighter ones as well and shoot them while they're vulnerable.
Usually, like, if they have, like, a fort there, but if you can get rid of that fort, you can pretty much just land all your men and stuff freely, and you have the support of your ships.
Sure.
Whereas if you do it the other way, you won't. Like, I remember in Age of Empires, I'd take out those things on the edge, then drop my men off there, then you just have free reign, and you're ignoring the walls and anything else they had on the other side.
We do have a convergence of these two storylines coming together with Ash's daughter, because Ash was the one that stood up
in the past
and decided that he was, like, what do you need me to do to help? So... Dude, I don't know how that works. I mean, how's that going to come together?
That'd be terrible, him being like, okay, I'll help you with the pardoning of these pirates. It sounds like a good idea, and now the pirates have his daughter.
Now he's going to be super pissed.
Yeah.
What was this, 10 years?
Yeah.
10 years, I think. Okay. The flashback.
Yeah, because it's 1715 now, and it was 1705 back then.
Yep. Yeah, 1705.
I can't believe they stuffed his dad like that, too.
No, England, 1705.
I didn't see any of
that. I still can't
tell my father to get out of his own house.
I still can't figure out if Hamilton knows that Barlow is sleeping with Flint.
I don't think he's a stupid man. But I think he allows it.
He said he's not a stupid man, but sometimes it's the people closest you can't really see.
Yeah. There was a moment, though, where, like, he was just standing, like, over there, and she, like, not about us, you know? Like, touching him, and I was like, this kind of seems...
They're both...
Get away!
You'd be cool,
damn it! Stand over there!
They both seem so loyal to him.
They do. Yet,
are they betraying him?
What made me question it was, I think Flint, at the dinner table, he got mad after she got insulted.
Yeah.
But then he stood up and said he was defending him.
That's true.
Which is why I think he might be hiding it from him. But it's hard to say.
I mean, he could also just be like... He he's a good man. I'm going to defend the good man.
I'm sure he believes that, but, he didn't stand up until he talked about her.
I think because at that point it was starting to drag on. The conversation was starting to get out of control. Well, all right, now I got
to
speak up.
The dad's also starting to make it personal about people rather than just talking about the issue.
Keep your mouth and your legs shut and stuff like that. He's like, get out of your house.
And the thing is, he's totally correct. Yeah. Like, she sleeps around.
I mean,
at least with him.
We say, is there an issue with what's going on there? But at the same time, in the present, we have Jack and Anne and Max like doing this banging thing.
I don't like Max versus Jack at all. I'm glad that I think they're working their stuff out. I think she's helping him, because I was like, I don't want this subplot like where they're fighting over her.
Yeah,
you know. But I'm glad that's not a thing.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, they're all okay with what's going on with that. Sure. Like, there could be the Hamiltons and Flynn are okay with what's going on over there.
The Hamiltons don't have any children, do they?
I haven't seen any.
No.
Maybe he's impotent. Maybe it's like a thing. Like,
maybe, but he was also like talking about God and Protestant and stuff like that, and
forgive others, so God
isn't exactly.
I really loved that the thing that he said about that. It's like, you know, we follow the Son of God, but you guys can't base your legislation off of forgiveness.
Sure.
You know? Yeah, he said, that's the point.
Forgive others, so God will forgive you. And his dad was like, "You're not. You know, you're acting like a little kid, or you're being naive."
Sure.
To protect traitors is a traitor.
That's not how things really are. You know what I mean?
But so Hamilton's wanting to change the way things are.
But and what sucks is we know he fails.
Mm-hmm.
We just don't know why or what happens.
I think the downfall of everything is fucking he finds out the affair.
Maybe.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Which makes it all, actually, it just really makes it a lot more tragic and interesting.
The priest is talking about God. I think Charles Vane is the God of this world. You should be worshiping him.
Right. Like, that guy just, like, you know, I don't know where the hell he thinks he is.
I don't know.
You know? Like, what do you expect? She runs this shit, right? She's got to get her hands dirty.
I wish I had a little more silver, but that's cool. I liked him going to beach paying people.
Billy Bones.
Billy Bones is back. Yeah, he wants to speak to Gates, so I don't know, maybe.
Does he want to speak to Gates because he want to be like, Gates, he pushed me in the water?
Yeah.
You want to speak to Gates because he's like,
we were wrong.
We were wrong. He didn't do this.
And I fell.
They must have given him a message and dropped him off, right? He didn't just escape. Not in that condition.
Not with the leather guy, yeah. The guy that was
shrinking. The leather guy.
Leather daddy, yeah.
I mean, what if it's going to be
Schaefer's leather?
Like, they're coming. They're going to be here soon. And they're going to have this whole war going on where it's not going to be good. It's going to be bad.
I don't know.
Or maybe he escaped.
But why would you ruin the element of surprise by sending Billy back?
Scare him away?
Yeah, just keep him away from the Urca gold.
I don't know. I really don't know.
I have no idea. Mm-hmm. I don't know. We got to learn. We got to figure it out. I agree.
I mean,
one more silver.
Why do the British know about the Urca gold? Is the thing?
I don't know. I have no idea.
They might just be coming in to try and take care of the pirates, but then the pirates know about the gold and the British.
Didn't they say something about the British would be coming to help with the Urca?
No, I think.
No, that
I think
was
they were
all
talking about King Philip getting the Spanish gold back.
And the guy that had Billy is connected to the guy that came for Gunthery in season one, right?
Talking about,
they're part of the same navy. But I don't know what the connection is, really.
Oh, he said something, that guy said something about, like, this is something
Bryson?
I learned from the Spaniards, right?
Right.
Yeah, Bryson.
So, I mean, he has some connection to the Spaniards.
Yeah, okay.
He's
tortured, I don't know.
Maybe. Been hanging out with Spaniards, works with Spaniards.
I need to listen to Silver's Rumor Volume 5. Maybe before last
it.
Time,
yeah.
Volume
5. Jack is also a new captain. I mean, he's already a captain, but he has acquired a ship now and 20-something
men. Well, tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning, 20-something men.
28.
Yeah.
Maybe more than that if they end up just doing a voting.
I want to give out to Vane.
Crew.
But, you know.
I mean, Vane, what ship does he have?
He has
Lowe's.
Ned Lowe's
that's
ship.
Right.
It's the fancy.
Do you think Bonnie's going to stay with Max or go with Jack?
I think she's going to go with Jack. Based on that conversation.
I hope she goes with Jack.
Because I hope she goes to Jack. And I think it's the right thing for her to go to Jack. I think she'll probably go with Max.
I hope.
It'll make us go, what the fuck? Is this shitty, you know? And that's what I think will happen, even though I don't want it to happen.
I think Bonnie will go with Jack, and Max will stay.
This show always goes against reason. Like,
at the
Flynn
end.
At the end, and, you know.
Fire!
Yeah, the show goes against reason. I think it's very, the right thing is to stay with Jack, and she won't do it.
I mean, I'm just saying
the
way.
In the fact that she was saying to him, storytelling, like, you know, like, I know this, you and I have been together since we were younger. You know, there's no way she can come between you and me. Because she said it won't happen, it will happen.
Max just is just, she's so damn competent.
She's so damn hot.
And confident. I don't know how the hell she was in the position she was in season one if she has been like this, you know?
I don't know either.
She was just distraught over Eleanor.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
Yeah, she was putting herself in a position of convenience for Eleanor and not necessarily for herself.
I wonder what's going to happen with Eleanor's dad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, what is he going to bring?
Quiet!
And is he being truthful? I mean, he's already betrayed her at least twice, right?
There's definitely the one time.
Definitely the one time.
And then I guess, I mean, there's the first time of him just showing up, I guess, and just saying he's done, whatever else, without, and then there's the next time with whoever that one guy was, the captain.
Mm-hmm.
With the slaves and Scott and all that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right.
So I don't know. I don't know. Number one, should she trust him? Number two, what is he going to, what, how's Bryce. He going
to
help?
I don't know. We'll have to find out next time.
Thank you guys for watching. If you guys want to see next week's episode already, make sure you guys check out patreon.com/blindwave or the website as well. And then make sure you guys subscribe for all Blind Wavy things all the time.
Stop it.
Check the description.
What for?
Everything. Uh-huh.